Hello friends, welcome back to my channel again. In this video we are going to learn about how to reset, factory reset the Palo Alto firewall. So in order to do the reset or factory reset, you need to have a console access. When I mean console, serial console access to the firewall. Considering that you have a hyper terminal or a putty session, putty software, where you have taken the firewall into a serial port, either it could be COM 1, 2, 3, 4, based on your system configuration, you have to connect to the COM port and take the console first. And use the default credential what you have configured on the device first. As soon as you logged in, type the command called debug system maintenance mode and click enter, and it will ask for a question, yes or no. Click yes. It will take the device into a maintenance mode console. So when I mean maintenance mode console, that's where the factory reset option will be availed, and from there we can do a reset of a device. So the device will get reboot in order to take into that console. Please wait for the device to respond you back so that you can continue to complete the factory reset configuration. Please remember that this step that I'm explaining here is most common for across all the Palo Alto firewall model. So you don't need to worry about having a different types of options to be followed. But consider that this is a hardware based firewall, but if it is a software, you might not need to think about it, because you will have a new image or VM will be created based on your need. Definitely we don't need to do a factory reset over there. Okay, the device is still rebooting. We'll wait for it to come back. So it will ask for you to enter the device into a maintenance mode, or do you want it to go to the direct booting operation. This is similar to normal other firewalls only. After 5 seconds, it will let the device to go into the ROM monitor mode, which is similar way that we consider on the Cisco firewall side. So in about a couple of seconds, the system will come on to a console where we need to initiate the factory reset operation. We'll wait the system to come back. Please remember, you will have to have the console access to the firewall until the end of the full reset operation, because if in case the system asks for any app questions in middle, you will need to have the console screen to be visible for you, so that you can interactively answer to that. Okay, we are on the console now. That is called the maintenance recovery tool. Click continue. Select that specific button and click enter. It will let you to go to the next window, where you have to select factory reset, which is on the third from the top. Select that and click enter. So once you click enter, the system will ask you a couple more information as a warning to you. Don't worry about it. Don't select anything. Go down all the way below and select factory reset. Okay, from here hit factory reset option. Leave everything else as it is, and it will start to wipe out the configuration what is there in the hardware, including the password credentials what you have set it up on the device. So as soon as the wipeout operation completes in about 5-7 minutes, the system will be ready for you to log in using the default credentials of that specific model. Okay, keep that ready, and we will come back and to log into the system as a fresh. Okay guys, okay, from here we see 18% of factory reset is complete. It will take a minute, next 2 minutes to complete the wipeout configuration. Okay, let's wait for a second to come back the console. Okay, the wipeout is done. The status is now showing as a success. From here we are ready to reboot the device. Click hit of a reboot option. It will let the device to reboot to restart all its own services, and by the next time it boots up, it will show the default name of host name of the device, and it will ask us to enter the default username and password. By then we will also be asked to enter the new password. Whether you can reset the password on the CLI console or from here, you can take the console through management port, and from there you can try to change the password. Okay guys, that's all for today. I think I have covered the necessary information around how to do the factory reset of Palo Alto Firewall, and the necessary prerequisites and the components associated for you to perform the factory reset. Okay, we'll catch up in the next video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel, and please like, comment and share. That way it will give a motivation for me to keep continuing my post and as a continual process. Thank you so much. We'll catch up again. Bye bye.